Father, we come to you today. We know we're standing in your presence. And we've set this day aside that we might pray for those all over America who are hurting financially, who are gripped by a spirit of fear, who need to be set free, and who need to receive your anointing. We come now to pray for each of us assembled here, and for those who are being sharing in a webcast all across this nation and wherever else they are in the world. We would ask a special anointing and special blessing in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You all can be seated. God bless you. We have a wonderful group here in our studio, people from CBN, people from Regent University who are here. We have received, for prayer requests, 179,465 prayer requests, and we've only announced this for about a week, which tells me that there are people in this audience and all across this land that are hurting tremendously. And this is the time we set aside to pray for them. Now, here's some of the prayer requests that have come to us, just to give you a feeling of the needs of people. Tammy has said, I need an increase in financing. My husband was laid off, and his new job pays about one half of the salary we made before. We're a family of seven. Cheryl writes, or calls in, our home is being foreclosed on, and we need to find a new place to live within the next month. We're praying for God to open doors for our new home. We also have two children in college and two elementary age children still at home. We have limited income and need a financial miracle. Carol says, I'm 60 years old and I got laid off from my job of 10 years. I've been actively looking for employment for over a year. Please pray that a job opens up. Cindy says, I lost my job a month and a half ago when the company closed after many years of being in business. My husband and I live in a very small city, and there's not that many job opportunities. We don't believe we should move. Please pray that I'll get a job. Mary says, I have a lot of bills that are far beyond my catching up. It seems like such a hopeless situation. I ask for a financial miracle. Sherry says, I need prayer for peace of mind. I have been stressed, tired, fearful, and angry about my job in the future. I need to feel the peace that comes only from God. Lacey says, I have had trouble with cutting for 5 years, and I have attempted suicide twice. I think I have gotten better now, but I want to be sure. I'm scared I may do it again. I don't ever want to go back there. I want to be completely healed because it was such a horrible time in my life. Susan says, please agree with me for the deliverance of my whole house from false doctrines and unbelief. And somebody has diabetes, Crohn's disease, high blood pressure, a mass in the thyroid. There's a marriage that needs healing and restoration, a lot of hurt in that marriage. And somebody says, I'm suffering from rheumatoid arthritis and have been having a lot of pain in my body. My husband also suffers from high cholesterol and other illnesses. We've been having a lot of pain in his arms and legs. Please pray for us that we see the Lord heal us both. Folks, there are people who really are hurting. The level of pain is beyond belief. Somebody's lived in a home for many years, and now they're being evicted from that home. Somebody's had a job for 10 or 20 years, and now they don't have any source of income anymore. They've been laid off, and they're among the unemployed. All over this country, people are saying, we're hurting. And along with that hurt has come fear, a gripping spirit of fear. And fear causes torment, but it also causes paralysis. Inactivity. When somebody's gripped by fear, they can't do anything. They're just paralyzed as to what to do next. Now's the time to pray. And before we introduce message of hope for some of them. I just think we ought to start right now by praying. This is a prayer time. So folks, join hands right now and hold before you 180,000 prayer requests. Father God, we come before you at this special time that we've set aside for prayer. We believe, God, that you are the answer. You're the only answer. Lord, these people are hurting. They're suffering. They're in desperate condition. And they've been gripped by fear. Now, fear has torment. But the Bible says perfect love casts out fear. Now, we come with perfect love to cast out fear from people's hearts. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we cast out a spirit of fear that has been haunting and dogging people. You spirit of fear, we bind you and cast you forth from people's lives. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, fear shall be banished. And perfect love shall take its place. Lord, fill the people with love in their heart. May they be overflowing with the love of Jesus. And we know that in Christ, all things are possible. Now, Lord, you're going to take care of the finances. You're going to take care of the sicknesses. You're going to take care of the marital problems. Lord, with you, all things are possible. And we agree together right here, right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bless you now. We bless you for what you're going to do. Lord, amaze us. Amaze us with how you're touching people's lives. Amaze us with what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. We have a story now of a couple who thought God had abandoned them. Clifford and Lillian Rosa were down to their last $7. They were terrified about the future, and they were about to give up until Rosa prayed and God answered Rosa's prayer. Just watch this as we continue.
Life is good for Clifford and Lillian Rosa, living in beautiful Hawaii near their daughters and grandchildren. Plus, Clifford has a very successful construction business. While their lives are full of prosperity now, there was a time not so long ago when the Rosas fell into $40,000 of debt.
We started to really decline financially, and everything came to us almost like a standstill, just began to shut down. But all of a sudden, it was upon me that we were totally in debt.
We took our eyes off God as the supplier of our needs. And to me, that's our downfall, was we took our eyes off God.
As a result, they lost their home.
I lost everything I had. I mean, literally lost everything I had.
You know, during that period, we had nothing. There were times we only had rice and soil to eat.
The financial stress was so bad that Lillian fell into a deep depression.
Physically, it took a toll on me. I got very sick, and everything was really hard. My husband is always the full of faith and always looking to God that he's going to supply our needs, and I knew God would. It's just that I wanted it now. I didn't want to wait. You know, there were many nights I slept on the sofa in the living room because I couldn't lie down because I had a hard time breathing. And I would sit there and ask God, do you know who I am? Do you see me? Do you care?
The Rosas had been faithful tithers for years. And despite their seemingly insurmountable debt, they kept giving, believing in God's faithfulness.
We never ever stopped tithing or giving. Even though we did not have money for food and we barely had anything to eat, we still tithe.
Clifford says the ultimate challenge came when God asked him to give the last few dollars he had to CBN to help the hungry.
I'm going to take this $5. I had a little bit more, but I said I would take this $5 and I'm going to feed the hungry with this $5. And I know my house didn't have, but it was okay. And I went down to the post office. And as I was walking to the post office, believe it or not, I didn't hear an exterior voice, but I knew in my heart, God said that wasn't all. And I had to go. I had $2 more in my pocket. And I took out the $2 more and I opened the envelope again, put the in total of $7. It was cash because we didn't even have a check in or savings.
After Clifford's obedient surrender to God, things started turning around. Business increased, and soon they were completely out of debt. And Lillian was delivered from despair.
We have hope. Even though everything is gone, there's hope because God will, he'll make a way when there is no way.
God even redeemed the Roses' foreclosure. The man who bought their home became their landlord, asking the Roses for only half the market rate for rent. And that's not all. Clifford desperately needed a new truck for his rejuvenated business. And one day,
I open my mail and I look at this check, and this check says, $35,000, $35,039 or something like that. I look at this check, is this a bona fide check or what? So I picked up the rest and I recognized the insurance company names and the things that I had invested in years ago. So I looked at it and I told my wife, God bought us our truck. She said, what? I said, God bought us our truck. Take a look at this.
It was money from an insurance policy Clifford bought when he was 19. He hadn't even thought about it in years.
It was unbelievable. You know, because it was money we did not have. It just came, and there was enough to buy the truck that he wanted. That's how big our God is. He knows your heart, he knows what you need, and he can give it to you.
Praise God. Amen. There are people who are in this audience today who are hurting. Well, you saw what the Roses did. The last $7 they gave to feed the poor. And God gave back many, many, many fold beyond that. We've got to break the cycle of poverty, and we've got to break the spirit of fear that is upon people. We've got to see God move. And so we're gathered together here in a spirit of humility, in a spirit of faith, to cry out to the Lord and say, God, we need you. There are certain problems beyond our help. We can't do anything in our own strength, but with God, all things are possible. I want to read you something from Isaiah. It's a great part of the Bible, Isaiah chapter 60 and beyond. And here's what he promises. He says in chapter 60, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the people. So all over this earth, there is fear, and there's darkness, and there's confusion, and appall. The Bible says, but the Lord, Jehovah God, rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look about you. All assemble and come to you. Your sons come from afar and your daughters carried on the arm. Then you will look and be radiant. Your heart will throb and swell with joy. The wealth on the seas will be brought to you. To you, the riches of the nations will come. Herds of camels will come to cover your land, young camels of Midian. And all from Sheba will come bearing gold and incense and proclaiming the praise of the Lord. All Kedar's flocks will be gathered to you. The rams of Nebaioth will serve you. They will be accepted as offerings on my altar, and I will adore my glorious temple. That's what God says. Foreigners will rebuild your walls, and their kings will serve you. Though in anger I struck you, in favor I will show you compassion. Your gates will always stand open. They will never be shut day or night, so that men may bring you the wealth of the nations and their kings in triumphal procession. Now, that's the way God wants to do it. He says, it's going to be so much money coming in, you can't shut your doors because it's going to keep on coming in. Night and day, it's going to come pouring into you. That's his promise. Amen. That's what he says. Praise God. Your gates will be open night and day. Great flocks of animals will come, and the gold and the silver will come, and merchandise will come from all around the world. And the gates will not be shut day or night to accommodate the flood of what God's going to do. That's what he said, you know, in the book of Malachi. He says, prove me with your tithes and offerings if I want to open the windows of heaven and pour you out such a blessing you cannot contain it. So much you cannot contain it. That's what Isaiah is saying here. It's going to be so much coming in. You'll have to leave your gates open all the time just to get the money in. That's a good thing to do, isn't it? Instead of being out on the street begging, God says, the psalmist said, I've been young and I'm now old and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. And some of you who are in other parts of the nation or in the world, you've been suffering and struggling right now. And God says, the time's going to come that I will open the windows of heaven and pour you out such a blessing you can't contain it. But we must be free of a spirit of fear. Fear not. God knows your name. He knows where you live. He knows who you are. And hallelujah, he's coming to your aid. Joel, come up here and pray for us, will you, brother? All right. Let's all pray again. We're believing God on this special time. There you go.
Father God, thank you that you hear us when we pray. Now we come in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you that you are here. And by the Holy Spirit, we can announce your kingdom's come. We welcome you, Lord. We just say we love your government. But Lord, at this time, our hearts are attuned to the suffering and the hurting. And as Dr. Robertson has read, those that are wounded in spirit, in their marriages, and they've suffered an array of all kinds of challenges and pressures. Yes. And we align ourselves in agreement with the word of the Lord. When it's asked, whose report do we believe? We shall believe the report of the Lord. Amen. We believe you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you are sweeping the nation, even as we ask now. In unseen ways, you're sending your angels as messengers. Lord, you are turning the day. Our hearts are towards you. Our hearts are towards the people that are suffering. And we believe you, Lord, that today is a day of victory. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have these things because of your mercies and how we found you faithful. We bless you, Lord. We honor you. Lord, we thank you that you enable us to pray this way. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Let's give him praise and worship. Thank you, Lord. We praise you and we bless you. Thank you, Lord. All things are possible with him, for him with whom we serve. All things are possible, Lord. Nothing is impossible. Now, Lord, we reach out across the nation and think of those whose houses are in danger of being foreclosed. We pray that you will stay the hand of the banker, stay the hand of the court agent, stay the hand of those who would bring about a foreclosure, and may the debts be settled in the name of Jesus. And we pray for those who have been laid off from work or whose businesses have closed up. We pray for jobs. We pray, oh Lord, for employment. We pray for the abundance, better than anything we've been able to ask or think. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Christy, come up here and give us a word. Pray. Give some encouragement.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Father God, we worship you, Lord. I just come against every spirit of fear, Father. Your word says that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. And I come against every blocking spirit. I come against every hindering spirit right now. In the name of Jesus, I cast down every imagination, Father God, right now. Father God, I thank you so much for the peace of God. Your peace, I speak that peace upon everyone's mind, upon everyone's life right now in the name of Jesus. And just like that woman in that testimony said that she took her eyes off of the Lord, we say, bring your eyes back unto the word of the Lord. Read the word, know the word, speak the word. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. What you speak, what you say will come to pass. Speak life into your life. Father, you are a good God. We stand in agreement with every person around the nation, around the earth, who is just holding on to the hope of you, Father God. We stand in agreement. We stand in agreement that it shall be done. We thank you so much for your power, Lord. You are a good God. You are a mighty God, and we serve you. We love you, and that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, that every tongue that rises up against us, Father God, you've given us the power to condemn in the name of Jesus. And I continue to condemn that spirit of discouragement right now. And I speak power, freedom, liberty, and love in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you.
Let's just praise the Lord. Let's raise the hands and just bless God. Thank you, Lord, for victory. Thank you for victory. Thank you for victory. Praise you, Lord. Victory. Victory. Hallelujah. Victory. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Brother, let's sing something. Where's our guy with the... There we go. Let's just keep on praising the Lord.
Thank you, Lord. So good, you've been so good, been so good, you've been so good, yes, you've been so good. We just want to thank you, Lord, and so we praise you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for lifting the burdens. Thank you for lifting the fear. Thank you, Lord, for reaching into people's lives and meeting their needs. Thank you, Lord, for healing their bodies. Thank you, Lord, for healing their marriages. Thank you, Lord, for healing their finances. With God, everything is possible. With God, all things are possible. Lord, we come to you and we confess and admit that with God, all things are possible. All things are possible, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. All things are possible. Thank you. Now, people have got financial problems. God is going to solve the problems. Thank you, Lord. With God, all things are possible. All things are possible. Thank you, Lord. All things are possible. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. All things, say it, all things are possible. With God, all things are possible. Thank you, Lord. Financial burden is lifting. Illness lifting. Cloud over your marriage lifting. With God, all things are possible. Thank you, Lord. Wherever you are right now, reach out your hand to the Lord and just say, Lord, all things are possible with you, and things are possible. And I receive the blessing in my life right now. I receive it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. All things are possible. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, bless God. Gordon, you're here, and I want to just give you part of 180,000 prayer requests. Take these and do with them. Let's believe God for a miracle. Come on, I'll get out of your way. Here you go.
Lord God, we just lift these to you right now. And Lord, we just come before you now, and as a nation and for this nation, we repent and we turn. And Lord, even though our money says in God we trust, we haven't been trusting in you. we've been trusting in other things. We've been trusting in our own ability, and we have allowed our greed to overtake us. And Lord, for our financial institutions, for our banking system, Lord, we just repent and we turn. We didn't build on solid ground. We built on shifting sands. And we thought it would go on forever. And Lord, for our own finances, we've mortgaged ourselves to the hilt. We've borrowed against credit cards. We've become slaves to lenders. And Lord, we ask for mercy. And we ask for forgiveness. And we ask that you turn our hearts. Lord, we've been enticed and led away by material things when we should have been seeking your face. So, Lord, in your mercy, forgive. In your mercy, restore. In your mercy, give us a love once again for your law, for how you want our finances to be ordered, that we would put you first and not our desires, let alone our needs. So, Lord, forgive. 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 And, Lord, cause our hearts to turn. Issue the call over America, over the world, that we would seek your face. Lord, if you will call, we will run after you. So don't hide your face from us, Lord God. Let your face shine upon us. Lift up your countenance on us once again. And give us your peace. Lord, the reason this fear is gripping us is we lack your peace, your shalom, the assurance that we're in your hands, that you're guiding our destiny, that you shape our future, that all things are working together for our good. So, Lord, come and fill us once again with your love, for your perfect love casts out all fear. And Lord, give us the assurance once again that you hold our future. You hold our future. And it is you. You revealed this to your friend Moses. It is you that give the power to gain wealth. You give the ability. You give the wisdom. You give the creativity. We did none of it. You planted this land. You raised the cross on our shores. So, Lord, remember. Remember, and in mercy, remember your people. And for those who have written in, for those who have called in, remember. And we claim right now that you're able to put streams into the desert, that you're able to provide for your people, that you love the remnant, Lord. So for each one of these, we just speak provision and we claim over them your great promise that you supply all our need according to your riches and glory. So, Lord, right now, we just speak provision into every family represented here. We speak supernatural provision. And, Lord, I ask for creative ideas that they would see a way out, that they would hear a voice behind them saying, this is the way, walk in it. You make a way where there seems to be no way. You make paths in the ocean. So, Lord, reveal that to your servants. Lord, send now prosperity. Send now security. Not the security the world gives, but the security you give. Your peace, your love, your righteousness, your joy. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. For all of you that have joined us on the internet, on the World Wide Web, God bless you. Keep praying. Remember that with God, there's always an answer. Don't depend on your own ability. Depend on the ability that God so freely gives. God bless you. We'll see you again. Amen.
This again. Praise the Lord. Well, let's bow for the benediction. Thank you. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in victory. God bless you. Thank you.